The sound of the city, the good neighbor city, the sounds of Buffalo are mixed with daylight's glimmering rays and moonbeams shimmering glow. When darkness settles on the city, night sounds slowly come awake. Faint is the thunder of Niagara. Soft is the murmur from the lake. Hear the sound of the city, the sounds that are heard in Buffalo.
Iconic theme. the WEBR theme. Mary-Kate O'Connell, our guest this hour on the Jack Oroho radio program.
And Rosie.
There's Rosie.
That was her harness doorbell, I guess.
Yeah, Rosie's shaking around a little bit. It's so good to have you with us today.
Jack, before we start, I just want to say how awesome it is to have WEBR back. And back in the saddle with Jack Oroho is pretty awesome.
Yeah.
It's pretty great.
Every 50 years I reappear.
There we go. There we go. He's the phoenix that comes out of the sound tracks. But, you know, when WEBR when you guys came back, it felt like an old friend.
Well,
it really does.
That's what we're trying to do. Is speaking of old friends and alike.
nice segue.
Yeah, nice segue. Mary-Kate and I have done a little bit of theater two seasons ago. We did Painting Churches, and I was
beautiful.
I was so thrilled to be back on your stage back then.
Okay.
But a question of the day, an inside baseball kind of thing. South Buffalo, Irish lass from a great Catholic family, finding the theater. Or did the theater find you?
Well, I have to tell you, I'm a North Buffalo Irish lass.
Well, now you are, though.
No, I always was.
Where are you? I thought you lived in South Buffalo.
Nope, I spent a fair amount of time there. But, yeah, we were in St. Rose of Lima Parish.
Oh.
Went to Holy Angels, you know.
Okay.
My first job was sample shop, so I could walk everywhere.
See, my information was incorrect.
That's all right. I will always take the moniker that I'm from South Buffalo. I like that,
yeah,
too.
I thought you were down there. Well, how did you get into the theater, or did theater find you? How did that work?
I'm pretty sure it had to be a little bit mix of both. You're born with it. It's just something that really grows, and if you nurture it, you don't, ignore it or try and push it down. It stays with you, and it's awesome because it's a wonderful opportunity to be able to express yourself. And I love the old classics. There wasn't a day that we didn't play albums or even the big band era at my house when we were growing up. Just loved it. Loved all of the beauty and the nuance of movies. And then when I became able to go to New York or go see shows, all of a sudden it was a whole new dimension.
Do you remember the first show you did here?
First
show you did. Probably back in high school days, right?
Oh, yeah, for sure, high school.
You did a lot of musicals back then.
Yeah. I did. You know what I did at Holy Angels? I did Call Me Madam, which still remains one of my favorite musicals of all time. You know, it's the musical based on Pearl Mesta and Irving Berlin. Great music.
And then it was off to New York for you for a little while, wasn't it?
Yeah, just like a flash in the pan, really. It was... I went there and auditioned and met some great people. And as fate would have it, my dad passed. So I, just came back before anything could really get started. And I haven't looked back or regretted a moment of it.
Now, how many years has O'Connell and Company been around?
Well, this is our 25th anniversary season.
Yeah.
I know, pretty great.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not happy to spend it, in quarantine, but...
Yeah, in fact, that's another subject we're going to talk about. The entire theater community has been closed down now since March. Everything's dark, all the theaters.
Yeah.
And it's been a rough year for a lot of people. But the theater community, boy, they really got nailed. I mean, they had a lot of shows in progress.
Yes.
And then all of a sudden, well.
We had just finished our show of Glorious, and we were getting ready to mount the next production when all of this came really crashing down. We had very little, you know, warning. Many of the theaters, I'm sorry to say, had to, you know, just open, not even open a show. I think someone closed on their preview night.
Yeah.
And that's heartbreaking.
It is. Because absolutely.
Perhaps people don't know how much work goes in. And, you know, we're rehearsing for 6-8 weeks prior. Then we're running the show from 4 to 6 weeks or 7 weeks. And it's a lot of, it's a huge commitment, and but it's made out of love. And it's made out of vision and creativity. And the audience is a big part of our formula. You know, we're here to entertain them. We're here to engage them in 2+ hours of getting away from everyday stress and strain.
Yeah, Buffalo is a great theater town.
It's amazing. It's an amazing theater town.
Yeah, you know, people are just, you know, take Shays for an mm-hmm. instance. You know, the sellout crowds, show after show after show.
Well, they have a really good program at Shays. They're, I think Michael Murphy is a wonderful, wonderful executive director. And, you know, Al Nocciolino brings all the shows in that are winners.
Let's talk about Shays for 1 minute.
Sure.
Talk about your dad, George O'Connell.
Yes.
He was very instrumental. In fact, the instrumental instrument to get Shays Buffalo back after many, many years of just sitting there.
Yeah, because I think Lowe's Tech had it. But Dad was a controller of Buffalo at that point.
He was. Yeah.
And they had already voided, I believe they voided their contract and were in violation and pretty much just staying in the building. And there was a window of time that the city could take the building, and my dad went and got bicycle chains and chained all the doors from the inside.
I remember that story, yeah.
And just had wonderful friends of O'Connell and the friends of Shays. Shays O'Connell, actually, that's what the Friends of Shays O'Connell is called, that stayed there and just really guarded this beautiful treasure and discovered more treasures that were buried in the basement and underneath the beautiful oil paintings. So I think it's in constant restoration mode, and that's just a credit to the city.
Yeah, the restoration is just marvelous. It's a showplace.
Oh, it
really
is. It really is.
It really fantastic.
Yes.
We want to talk a little bit, too, about your thoughts on when you're going to be opening again or when you hope to open. The governor is talking about the Broadway opening in 2021, mm-hmm. not going to open at all. But I heard some rumors that Shays may be opening in December with a show. Is that correct?
Yeah, Shays did make an announcement, I believe last week or maybe a little longer ago, that they were shooting to open with Tootsie in December 1st, I think. And I can only hope and pray that they can stick with that because, you know, Jack, every day is a new deal. We listen to the governor. We listen to our county executive, both of whom I applaud. And I believe they've really done a wonderful job to bring us this far, and hopefully they'll all stay in, you know, in through this, the ending of this. But we don't know the protocol. We hear things like you're in phase 4.
Does that mean exactly?
Yeah, right. Exactly. It has a new definition almost every day. So we are just diligent, and we are absolutely following all the guidelines. We're involved, all the instructions. There's really no option because we all have to take care of each other.
Yeah.
And
the social distancing situation and the masking, you know, Shays could probably do that because it's such a big house. You know, they could probably do something to keep people apart. But the smaller houses in town.
Which also even think, though, Jack, about the, with Shays, is that you have to remember, it's not just the seats. It's the people coming into the theater,
people
walking up the stairs, the people using the restrooms, the people, you know, I don't even know if they're going to have concessions that you can buy. I doubt food, but, you know, or even like T-shirts or whatnot. And that's big. It's all part of the theater experience. But getting back to your question about the smaller theaters, as soon as we're given what the actual numbers, the percentages have to be, at this moment in time, to the best of my knowledge, we are we don't have an opening date, but they are saying that it has to be at least 50% or less, and every person has to be 6 feet apart. At our place, we may very well have to alter the entrance and exit from the theater, that they come in one way and go out another.
Of course, a lot of people don't know where you are right now, because last year you were over at the Park School, and now at the end of last year you moved over to Elmwood Avenue.
That's right. September of 2019, we opened at the Elmwood Commons, the Kenton Elmwood Commons, which is on Elmwood Avenue between Sheridan and the expressway, I guess.
Right, yeah, the 290.
The 290. Right. And, but it was called the Philip Sheridan School, for those who are in the neighborhood or have, you know.
I worked on that stage.
There we go.
The theater with the Kenton players, yeah. The town players, actually.
So once we moved in, which was fast, we moved in September, and we had a full stage production of Young Frankenstein on stage for, you know, the opening of the season.
That was a funny show, Mel Brooks show. Oh,
yeah,
hilarious.
Thanks. We had a ball.
But I think one of my favorite shows from O'Connell and Company has to be 1776. That was the greatest performance. The greatest performance that I've ever seen.
Thank you.
That had an all-women cast,
1776 is a memorable show for many reasons. It was our founding fathers, as we have always called them, but in this particular show, this musical, they were characters with a story. So characters with a story doesn't mean that it has to be men, woman, black, white. It's just tell the story.
Yep, Mary Kate, we got to take a minute here to pay the bills for a second.
All righty.
And we're back again with Mary Kate O'Connell this half hour. And we'd be remiss, Mary Kate, if we didn't mention your career in film.
I think it's adorable that you call it a career.
Well, whatever. Especially two movies that have become perennial winter classics. Maybe not classics, but nevertheless. The Christmas in Vermont. Mm-hmm. With Mary-Kate and Chevy Chase and Howard Hessman. How was Howard Hessman to work with, by the way?
He was a charm.
Really?
Really nice guy. Open to chatting with people, taking pictures. Many of the days we'd have lunch in the loosely constructed commissary. Yeah. He was just a charmer. He was a really nice guy, and he's one of the guys that he asked you how you were, and he waited to listen to see what you say.
You know, some of the big names are the nicest people, aren't they?
Yeah. He was just great. He had great sense of humor, and pleasure to share the screen with him as little as I did, but it was great.
Yeah. Before we went on the air, we were talking about, I was asking Mary Case how Chevy Chase was. And she said he wasn't even here.
No, he wasn't.
He wasn't even in Buffalo. He stayed in Hollywood, just did his thing, and picked up his money. And
I think that's kind of glamorous how they can do that, too. But everybody was kind of hoping to see him.
Yeah. Well,
It was an amazing group that was on that movie, too. Just really nice, nice people. And it was beautifully done. I always said it was a love letter to East Aurora.
Oh, yeah. But also, the one that I watch every season now, for the past couple of years anyway, A Prince for Christmas.
Yeah.
That's such a nice little story.
Oh, that's what I meant to say.
And you, and you, of course, were the running the inn and
yes.
convinced the prince to stick around because things were going to happen.
Yeah, you know? I kind of felt like the one that was the busybody, but she was also the big, you know, romantic. She was the yenta.
Yes, absolutely. And the whole thing wouldn't have been there if it wasn't for Mary Kate.
Yeah.
We're running out of time. I'm sorry to say. I thank you so much for stopping by today.
Jack, it's always such a pleasure to be in your company. Thank you. And again, I'm so happy WEBR is back.
Well, we'll have you back, of course, too, as soon as we have a schedule and know where we're going.
Count on me.
I'm looking forward to it. So, Mr. Engineer, could you play a song for us? Thank you so much.
Are we tap dancing
Yesterday
now?
Yesterday we had some rain, but all in all, I can't complain. Was it dusty on the train? P.S. I love you. Write to the Browns just as soon as you're able. They came around to call. I burned a hole in the dining room table. And let me see, I guess that's all.